I don't know why I'm doing this. Look, number two. Ooh, kom, open. Open! Thank you. That door sounds like the door for a very spooky house, which technically it is. I don't know, champagne gold, light gold, baby gold, I don't know. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, six looks with the cremated palette by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. This is what she looks like, but I think almost everyone knows. Yeah, so yeah, this is the last look of the video. I just got done finishing the review part of this palette. So if you want to know my thoughts and if I think it is worth the money, because she was expensive, she's a bougie one, you gotta watch that video. That should have gone online yesterday if all went well. It is linked underneath the cards. I created six looks with this palette. This is the last look. This is the look that I really one of the looks I really wanted to create with this palette. And what I did is I went largely row by row. So this is look number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then this should have been look number 6, but it wasn't, because I wanted to do something else. that is it. It's my video, I can do it. I have seen very, very bold and dramatic looks, which were gorgeous. They were very pretty looks, a lot of Instagram looks, which I love to watch. I wanted to create looks with this palette that were wearable, for me at least, versatile, everyday. I just wanted to show you how you can wear this palette on a day-to-day basis. And I hope I succeeded. I think I did. Did I throw in dramaticness? Oh yes, of course I did. Because that is apparently how I roll. This is dramatic for a lot of people. It is everyday wearable for me. Just saying. If you pair this with, I don't know, a different color eye pencil and a nude lip or a soft pink lip, it would be a lot more everyday. But I felt like this. Today. Timestamps will be listed down in the description box for all the looks. I will also list the makeup that I have on Z Face, and that is going to be it. Let me know down below if you have the palette, and yeah, let me know, I don't know, during the video if you like the looks that I did. Let me know down in the comment section. For now, I'm going to shut up. I'm going to insert the first look, because otherwise the video will be 5 hours long. It's probably going to be 45 minutes, but I hope to cut it down. But just to be on the safe side, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. Look one with the cremated palette, and I am going to do my eyes first, as I am prone to do. Look one is basically going to be row one, because those are the colors that I kind of want to play with today. And I think it is a nice way to spruce everything up. So what I'm going to do in the looks, I don't know if I said that in the beginning, but the plan is to kind of go row by row. However, I know that this one is a little bit yellower and this one is a little bit more gray. So if I need, for instance, a light shade to blend out a warmer toned, I'll grab this one, and when a gray, I grab this one. Let's start with the Sigma E45, yes, and the shade called Inheritance. So I'm just going to tap it into the crease. I'm going to go to another brush, and I'm going to go to the color called Obituary. And I'm going to use that here to blend out a little bit more. Make sure that I have a nice, well, basically a nice blend to my skin tone. I'm going to go back to the first brush, just to make sure that the blend is good. I'm going to go to the color called Hers. I'm going to deepen up everything with that. So let me grab my Morphe E36, which is a nice round bullet, kind of a small bullet brush. I'm going to define the crease a bit more, I think. Cool. Okay, then I'm going to go back to the brush. Let's go back to the Morphe that I used, the 506, a little bit in the color Inheritance, which was the darkest, to blend out this edge. Okay, then I'm switching to the Sigma E33 and the color Obituary, the lightest. Okay, NYX Glitter Primer and the flat brush. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create an faux cut crease. So first I'm going to tap it on my eye, the primer. And then I'm going to look down, stretch my eye up as far as it will go. And kind of clean up with the brush, creating a faux cut crease. Like that. Then I'm going to go into the shade Mausoleum. I'm going to press that on. And this is such a pretty shade. And because here I put down a little bit less glitter primer, I can fade it a bit better. I feel like I'm not making sense. But that's not new for me either. Now I'm kind of going to finesse everything. So I'm going to go to the darkest, to Inheritance first, which was the brownie shade. Then I'm cleaning that brush and I'm going to go into Hers, the black. I don't have any extra product, but I like to do that. Cool. Now I need an eye pencil and I think I actually want this one. I have here one from, I'm sorry, it's a house brand, but it's the color that I want. So this is the color, which is the same color that I have on my lid almost. And I just have this one. And I want to use it. So yeah, it's from Hema. It is a gel liner in, I don't know, I think it's taupe, but I'm not sure. This is what it looks like. Oh, bronze sparkle. That's the color. So it says so. It does say so here. Also going to bring it in my inner corner and around the tear duct. I'm going to go to the shade called Afterlife. Just this one. I'm going to put that in the inner corner. And then that is basically one eye done. I always forget the lip mask. But anyway, here's the look just before the falsies. I thought let's just finish off the face as well. So let me pick out a pair of falsies, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the final look. I like how it turned out. It is nice and smoky without being... I wanted to say without being dramatic, but it is dramatic, isn't it? For a lot of people. Not specifically for me, though. But the falsies I have on are my Londons that I get at Primark or in the style London. The lip combination is a pencil from NYX in the color Munchies, which is very cool toned. And then the lippy that I put on top is from Revolution. It's one of their creams in the color Hustle, which makes it a little bit, well, basically like this. Let me know down below what you think of this look. And let's get ready for look number two. And basically look number two is going to be largely this row. I don't know if I will use this one though or if I will use that one. So I'm going to start with the color called Embalmed, this one. It's going to go in the inner part of my eye or inner part of my crease. So this has sparkle in it, as you can see, I think. Can you see that? It is a very, very pretty shade. And I also kind of want to wrap that around, but I need a smaller brush for that. So I have here my Morphe E36. I'm just going to bring that around. Okay, let's go to the shade called Wednesday. It's more, I don't know, more like a banana powder. And to be quite honest with you, I would rather go in with the shade called Casket Ready, because that one has a little bit more gray. So I am going to grab this one. I can skip it. I know I can skip it, but I kind of do want to use a little bit of what I have there. You know, does that make sense? I don't know. So I'm going to blend out a little bit with Casket Ready. Maybe I will use the shade Burial Gown underneath my eye to set a little. Okay, let's grab the color Wednesday again, the darker. I really like this shade of gray, by the way. So I have my glitter primer. I'm just going to whack it on my eye. Then I'm going to go to the shade called Embalmed, this one. Now I know it's more of a... this one. It is more of a satin, but still, I don't know, there is something about this shade. So I'm curious to see how it performs on top of the primer. I think you can see the sparkles a bit more. I can see that it grips nicely, so that is good. So now I can kind of create a cut crease effect with the same shade. I don't know if you can see it, but I can see the line there and I like that. So I'm grabbing my Morphe E36. I'm going in the shade Wednesday. What I'm going to do now is going to grab my NYX glitter primer on my E36. I'm going to remove the excess on my hand and I'm going to press it on my bottom lid underneath my lashes. So I'm going to go to the color called On Wednesday first. Just placing it very low. And everything that I kind of mess up now, I can clean up while I'm doing my base. So I'm not really too worried. Then I'm going to go into the color Angel of Death. I'm going to press it on top of the glitter primer. I do think I need a little bit of black there, but I'm going to go to the matte black called Hers to just tie it a little bit together here. Just the outer corner. I'm just kind of flicking it in to fade it into. Again, I don't really want a dark upper eye. I want the focus to be a bit more there today. I'm going to think about an eye pencil. When you next see me, I will have my face. It will be basically just before the falsies and the lippy. Yes. Here is the look before the falsies. And I have decided on an eye pencil. I'm going to use this one from Kiko Milano in the color 11, which is a very deep teal. Because I think it will bring out kind of the sparkle that is in the black. Oh, I love this a lot. But as you can see, it is kind of bottom heavy now. Whew, I do think it's cute though. I am going to put on falsies as well. And they are going to be my Kylie's because they are a little bit spiky. But let me do that. Find a lippy. For inner corner highlight, I use the shade Diamond Ashes from the palette, which is gorgeous. A bit flaky, but very, very gorgeous. And it's really complemented this eye look. I did have a little bit of trouble pairing it with a lippy. Because the lippy that I wanted, I don't have. So yeah, there's that. I thought let's then go with this one. Because it has a little bit of an orangey in it. And I think it complements the blue that is in the grey very, very nicely. And it all kind of transforms into something a little bit more, I feel. So yeah, the lippy that I have on is from Menagerie Cosmetics. It is the shade Leo. Let me know down below what you think and let's get ready for look number 3. I'm going to start with the color called Gravedigger. So this shade is going to go into the crease, blend it out, and then I'm going to grab the lighter shade for the inner part and to blend it out a little bit more, and that's how I'm going to build up the look. I'm switching to a smaller brush for the color called Eulogy. I'm going to go into the shade called Burial Gown. Because it is a little bit more towards my skin tone. Basically not gray. And I kind of want to create a softer blend here. Okay, switching back to the smaller Morphe and the darker shade Gravedigger, the first shade. I'm going to go to the Morphe M507 because it has a little bit of a tip. I'm going to grab the color called Hers, the black. Because I'm going to put quite a dark shade on my lid, I want a little bit more definition in the crease. So I'm looking down. And I'm basically holding my brush like this against my eye, so that this tip touches the crease. Because I don't want the harsh black line. I just want it a little bit darker. And then I'm going to go to my previous brush. While looking down, I'm actually doing that so that it gets a little bit higher. Because I want a soft blend. So now I can kind of lay the brush flat against my skin. So it is time for the glitter primer. I'm going to do the same as I have been doing, I think, in the previous looks as well. Carve out a half cut crease. Then I'm going to go to the shade called Mortuary Beautician. And this is so pretty. I want to bathe in this shade. Okay, I am grabbing a small brush.
I can find it. Where are you? No, you're too small. Is this it?
Yes. I am going to go to the shade called Afterlife now. That's going to go in my inner eye part area. I'm not going to spray. I still have glitter primer there. It's going to pick up and deposit. Oh. I have not decided on the eye pencil just yet. So what I'm going to do is the rest of my face and then liner and mascara. And then you will be back. I will be back hopefully with a plan for an eye pencil. I don't really, still don't know what I want for eye pencil, but let's finish off the lower lash line anyway. I am going to grab the shade Eulogy. And I'm going to blend it underneath the eye. Then I'm going to go to the color called Gravedigger, the slightly darker one, and I'm going to place it a little bit higher. Ooh, that does pop, doesn't it? I don't know where it pops to, but yeah, I kind of like that. What I am going to do though is I'm going to grab that shimmer that I put on my upper eyelid on a smaller brush. And the shimmer is the color Mortuary Beautician. It's going to go on the bottom, but first glitter primer. If I know where I left it. So I have glitter primer on the back of my hand. I'm grabbing a bit with the brush. I'm doing the sexy face. I'm basically trying to press it underneath my lashes. I'm going to go into the color Mortuary Beautician. I'm going to press it on top. That is very cute with that yellow. Let's pull the yellow in a little bit more. Okay, I'm grabbing the color called Afterlife that I have in the inner corner. Yeah, the trouble is, I kind of wanted yellow and it's not really picking up. That's fine. I'm grabbing my BH Cosmetics highlight palette, yes. And I'm going to go for the color probably Double Trouble because it's gold, yellowy gold. I'm going to go for that one. Eyes are done, largely. The only thing I need to do is falsies and then a lippy. I just put on a lip mask, but I am very happy that I went with the yellow. I am going to go off camera, put on lippy and falsies, and then I will be back to show you the completed look. Again, I'm in a very dramatic mood today, hence the grey lippy. If you wanted a little bit more every day, maybe, I don't know if it is very every day for a lot of people, but if you wanted a little bit more every day, I don't know, you can pair it with a gloss, you can pair it with basically anything you want. This is going to be my everyday today. So yeah, that is it. I did pair it with my more natural falsies because I kind of wanted to keep the eye look a little bit softer. And then the grey lippy happened. The lippy is from VE Cosmetics in the shade called Anarchy. And on top of that, I just tapped a little bit of clear gloss in the center and did that. And that is it. This is it for look number 3. Yes. Let's get ready for look number 4. Okay, look number 4. And yeah, stuff happened there. So I kind of hope that the white balance setting is okay. Let's start with a bigger brush. And let's start with the color called... Do I want Cascade Ready? Sure, let's start with Cascade Ready. Because yeah, that's what I'm going to start with. I'm going to place it low. Press it on the eye primer. And then blend the edge a bit. Okay, so my base today really emphasizes texture. And I don't really know why. I don't think I use too much, but yeah. So if it is looking textured, it's because of that. It's not specifically the shade, but it doesn't help because it is such a light one, but that does not matter. I'm grabbing a different brush. It's going to go underneath my eye too. Okay, let's go to the shade called Life Insurance. Yes, this one. Let's see if we can darken it up a little. They do layer very, very nicely. So I'm going to go to that color now. It is called Death Certificate and it is a gorgeous, gorgeous color. So let's kind of, for fun, just use it as a matte because you can sometimes, but you create fallout. So I have it on the brush. I tap my brush off. I'm going to use it in the outer corner. and in the low crease. And now what I want is that base shade. So instead of really, you know, packing it on and having the oomph, I'm actually not... Oh, that's nice. Change of plans. It's going to go on my lid, but with a fluffy brush, no primer, and blend it. I actually quite like that. So let me get a brush for the lower lash line and my glitter primer. I'm going to pack it on my lower lid. Kind of underneath the lashes and maybe a little bit in between. And then I'm going to go to the color called Last Look. I'm just pressing it on top. I don't know if you notice a lot of difference though between the two shades. Maybe I can use this one to make it pop a bit more. I don't know, let's see. Yeah, I think that's cool. So this is one from Essence. It's a long lasting one in the gold shade, which isn't a very... It's not a bad pencil, but it's not really the gold that I usually want. It's I have it swatched here, so it's more of a, I don't know, champagne-y gold, light gold, baby gold, I don't know. I don't know. But I think that in this instance, it kind of lightens that color up a little bit more. So I do want to put it a little bit more on top because I want a little bit, I don't know, I want that definition a bit more. So instead of a gray bottom lid, I don't know, that golden-y shade gets a little bit more tan to cyan. I think I want diamond ashes in the inner corner. Oh yeah. And that's for funsies. Pull the shade Diamond Ashes a little bit more on top of the eye. Okay, and then here it is. So, am I still recording? Here it is so far. I'm going to put on liner, mascara and the rest of my face. Here is the look just before the falsies. It's nice. It's quite soft and I kind of like it. So let me put on a lippy, choose a pair of falsies and then I will be back to show you the completed look. Everything is on and here is the finished look. The lippy I have on is one from AliExpress. It's a Miss Young Fashion Matte in the color 11. It has a little bit of a yellowy undertone and it kind of helps bring out the yellowiness that I have going on in the lower lash line. It's not really yellowiness, but I kind of hope you get the vibe that I was going for. Let me know down below what you think of this look and let's get ready for look number 5. Let's start with the color called Last Respects. It's going to go in the crease largely. Tap it on first. That was a weird sentence. Okay. This is basically going to be my transition shade. Okay. I'm going to go into the color called Rest in Peace, this one. And I know they look very similar in the pan, but when I swatch them and when I put them on my eye, they are... Well, they pull together. So the first one was more of a brownish gray. Then this one seems to be more of a neutrally gray. And then the other one that I have seems to be more of a blue gray. And with the tip of this brush, I'm going to place it underneath my eye as well. Higher than the first shade. But still a little bit low. Okay, back to the first brush. And a little bit of the color, Last Respects, the first color, to just blend here on the outer part a bit. Now I'm going to go into the color called Solemnly Swear. And this is the E45 from Sigma. I'm going to use the tip to darken up the crease even more. Now if I were to use this shade to deepen up the first color, it will probably turn muddy. This is also the reason that I put the other color in between. So basically with these shades I kind of look at the base tone. So the first one had a little bit of a yellow base tone. The second one a little bit more of a greeny base tone. And then this one a little bit more of a bluey base tone. And that's the way that I can kind of use them together and blend without them turning muddy. And I'm just going to blend a little bit more in the crease. I'm grabbing my first brush without any extra product. Now I have the white left and I want to put that on the lid. Let me find the brush that I want to use. Okay, we are going to go into the white called Death Blow. It's going to go on the lid. Now my lid is still a tiny bit sticky, so that is good. I have here the Sigma E27. It looks dirty, it's not, it's stained. I thought about kind of doing a cut creasy idea, but I actually like this softness a little bit better. Okay, let me get a denser, a denser kind of brush to bring that white around a bit more. What I'm going to grab is a white eye pencil, just for funsies. Let's see, so I'm going to place it here around the tear duct and a little bit on top of my mobile lid in the beginning. Kind of tap it out a bit without poking myself in the eyeball. Then getting the color Death Blow, the white, and just I'm going to press it on top. Oh, that makes... Can I do that for my entire lid? Let's see. I don't know. I've never done this. Basically just kind of painting my eyelid with the pencil. Not all the way, because I kind of want to have a gradient. It doesn't hurt, but it's not really comfortable. Maybe I need to get NYX's Jumbo pencil. I don't know. Cool. So basically I'm using this as a base. That's nice. I kind of like this. What do I want to do with the bottom? I don't know. I do want it a little bit heavier. I like a heavy bottom. What can I say? I'm going to go into the color Solemnly Swear, I think. The darkest. Just going to pack it on a little bit heavier. I do want an inner corner highlight. Let's grab the shade Diamond Ashes. Just in the beginning. I don't want it on the lid too much. I just want it in the beginning and around the tear duct, you know? Maybe a little bit underneath the eye. Okay, that's not cool. I thought, let's do something. Sometimes you just don't need to do something. So let's go to the color called Mortuary Beautician. I wanted to keep this soft, but because I kind of did something there, I need to cover it up. And we need a darker shade for that. So let me, where's my spray? So I have the color. I'm just going to spray and I'm going to put that on. Really going to hang with my head forward, so hopefully I don't have too much fallout. Crisis averted. Note to self, don't be fancy. Or at least not when you only have half an hour. And then here is the look just before the falsies. So let me plop those on, kind of finish off the face with a little bit of blush and bronzer and such, lippy, and then I will be back to show you the final look. Everything is on and here is the finished look. The lippy I have on is, I have a base layer on of a non-cruelty free brand in the hopes that it won't travel. And then I have the NYX Turned Up lipstick in Dirty Talk, but because it is such a dark color, I kind of need, hopefully, to have a base layer underneath that will stop it from bleeding. I'm not sure if that will happen, but yeah, here we are, and this is the end of look number 4. Let me know down below what you think of this look, and let's get ready for look number 6. Yes. Wow, the last look of the video, and technically I should kind of play with the last row, but I kind of don't I kind of want to do something else. Ever since I kind of opened this palette, I wanted to recreate one of the looks that I did with the Grimoire, and that is a dark, well, basically a black smoky eye with the black. And I should technically use these, but I think I'm actually going to grab that one all over the lid. I think I'm going to set the base first. And I'm just going to use the shade called a Burial Ground. This one, Burial Gown, Burial Gown. Just lightly to set where I'm going to do the most blending. So that's basically here. I just want to tap it here. You see what I'm doing. I'm going to work with the black matte and the black shimmer. And it's going to be quite a thingy. So let's see if I can use one of these. So I'm going to start with a color called Hers. And that's probably the only, well, matte shade I'm going to use. Because I can. I don't know. I usually don't build up black smoky eyes with the brown first. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start low. And this is a process. So now that I've placed it there, where you see that I placed it, that is where I'm going to blend it. So the brush that I'm using now, I'm going to blend like that instead of flat. And then I'm going to work it in. So usually a look like this is just a lot of blending and a lot of patience. And I'm just slowly working it up and in. Not really doing circular motions because I find it easier to kind of, well, do the windshield wiper motions. And we are basically blended as well. So that is very, very nice. I'm going to kind of deepen it up in the crease a bit. I'm going to place it. And now I'm going to hold the brush kind of flatter to my eye because I don't want this to go too high up. But I do kind of want the blend. I'm going to do that until I'm happy with the blend and the placement. So I'm very, very slowly working it up. If you want a softer blend, what you can do now is take the first brush, tiny bit of the first shade or your face powder, and just very lightly blend the edge. I think they're kind of even. Let's grab a brush and my NYX Glitter Primer. I'm not going to be very, very precise. I can be if I want to, but I'm just patting it on my eye. Going to go to the shade called Angel of Death, the one that I have been wanting to smear on top of my entire eyelid ever since I got this palette. So let's do that. And this is a little bit... It's not really a... It is a shimmer black, but it also kind of has... glittery flecks in it, looking at it. Okay, I'm going to place it first. I'll finesse it in a minute. Okay, shade placed. And I have less fallout than I thought I would, which is good. I'm going to go back to the black called Hers. I'm just going to make sure that that shape is nice. Okay. Am I done? No. Because we're going to spruce it up. If I can find the right brush for that. I think I want the color Pallbearer. I haven't used it just yet, this one. Which is one of his special shades. Yeah, if I wiggle it around, it kind of does, but... Why limit myself? I have so many possibilities. I don't know if it will show up though, but let's do it anyway. So this is one from Essence. I will tell you... the color in just a second. Maybe I will look sick. Oh, it's actually quite cool. Okay, so this is an Electric Vibes, neon-y Electric Vibes liner in No Regrets. I think let's kind of go all out. I'm going to go to the color Mortuary Beautician because it has a nice shine. And I'm going to use that underneath my eye. I can never be neat underneath my eyes, but I can clean it up still. So that is the reason I'm doing this now. Do I want to shade Pallbearer there? Let's see. That is nice and shiny. That's the one thing I don't really like about these special flaky kind of shades. Colourpop uses them too. It's like I cannot pick them up with a brush, but I really like this. So the color Pallbearer went there. Then we're going to go to Diamond, the color Pallbearer. And now I'm going to go to the color called Diamond Ashes. And that is going to go in the inner eye part area. So here is the eye look so far. I can show you without the falsies, but it's going to look like this. But then with my base makeup on. So I'm going to skip that step and show you the completed look. So hold on tight, I'll be right back. I really, really like it. It is giving me the similar vibes as my first impression with the Grimoire palette that I will link underneath the cards. But because of that hot pink and then the hot pink lipstick, it is a little bit more cheery. Not less dramatic, but a little bit more cheery maybe. But yeah, this was the last look of the video. Let me know down below if you have a favorite look. This is one of the looks that I really wanted to do with this palette. There are more looks that I want to do with this palette. I just don't have time to do them right now. That is the gist of it. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys. I don't know, I do like it. Oh, I'm itchy. I have hairs everywhere. I'm a cat owner. That says it all, I think. And a dog owner. I have a husky, so maybe that's saying, you know, why I have hairs plastered to my face.